सर, गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल ऑफ यू. माय सेल्फ महेश जगदीश पिंगळे, लेक्चरर इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स इंजीनियरिंग, गवर्नमेंट पॉलिटेक्निक अंबड. सो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस कलर टेलीविजन ट्रांसमीटर. सो ऑन युअर मोबाइल स्क्रीन यू आर ऑब्जर्विंग द ब्लॉक डायग्राम ऑफ कलर टीवी ट्रांसमीटर. सो स्टेप बाय स्टेप वी विल डिस्कस each and every details regarding the color television transmission process. Dear students, when we transmit a signal, at the time we have to collect two signals. The first signal, which is related with the optical information or the video information which we want to broadcast, and the second signal is the audio signal, that is the information in terms of the sound energy. So suppose if we take the example, suppose you are observing a television or some news channel, and the anchor of that particular news channel is giving some information about any accidental news or anything. So at that time, a camera is focused on that particular anchor, which collects the video information and the movements of the anchor, the body language of the anchor, and at the same time a microphone is placed nearer to that particular anchor, which collects the sound energy of that particular news information. Means whenever we are recording the news details in that particular studio, we are recording two information. One is audio information, which is coming from the mouth of that particular anchor, and secondly the video information, that is nothing but the body language of that particular anchor. Now your television broadcasting signal is the combination of these two signals, audio signal as well as the video signal. So we have to process that audio signal and video signal before it get transmitted towards the satellite. Now in this particular lecture, we are going to discuss the different steps of audio processing as well as video processing of that particular information in your television transmitter setup. This lecture describes you the detailed blocks of each and every processing step of your video as well as audio information. Now, as all of we know that the India is using PALD system. So PAL stands for phase alternation by line, and D stands for delay line system. So phase alternation by line with some delay. Now to which signal we are providing that particular delay? The delay is provided to the luminal signal, that is called as Y, and it is basically of 64 microsecond, right? So that's why this particular PALD transmitter here we are going to discuss. Now the one of the important block in your PALD transmitter is the PALD encoder. Now this PALD encoder, it is the block which do the process of phase alternation by line. So in this PAL system, we have to alter the phase line by line, right? So that's why for doing such a kind of phase shifting line by line, we are using such a kind of PALD encoder. Now let us have a look over this total block diagram of color television transmission process or a color TV transmitter. Here this total block diagram, it is divided into 3 to 4 sections. The first section you are observing, that is color camera system. Then the second portion you are observing the PALD encoder. Then the third section you are observing, it is FM sound transmitter, and the last section, it is nothing but actual transmission of the signal and the combining networks. Now, step by step, we will discuss each and every block. So let us have a look over how the video information itself gets captured and it is converted into the PAL format. Now, as all of we know that the transducer which we are using for the video information collection and conversion of video information or the optical information into the electrical one, we are using camera. So camera is a transducer which converts your optical information into the electrical information. Now, as per the color theory, we know that if we have red color, green color and blue color, these three primary colors, then we can derive any shade of your color in your color television receiver. So if we are having RGB, then it is possible for us to derive any kind of color at the television receiver type. So the output of your color camera system, it is RGB, and that you are observing here. So a color camera system provides three output, that is red color, green color and blue color, that is called as RGB, and that RGB, it is given to your color matrix. Now, to that particular color matrix, you are also applied a sync pulse generator and frequency divider signal. Now, the output of color matrix is nothing but Y, U and V signal. Now, Y is nothing but your luminance signal. So, as all of you know that 0.3 of your red, then 0.11 of your blue and 0.59 of green gives me 1 Y. So, if there is a 100% luminance signal, if we talk about the percentage white distribution, then there is 30% of red, 11% of blue and 59% of green is there. So, combination of these three, we get a luminance signal that is called as the Y signal. Now, as all of we know that basically in your color matrixing circuit, R minus Y, B minus Y, G minus Y signals are generated, but for your transmission purpose, television transmission purpose, we are filtering the G minus Y signal and we are just generating the color difference signal R minus Y and B minus Y signal. Now, this particular R minus Y signal and B minus Y signal, then we are converting into the weighted color difference signal. So, at the output of color matrix, we are having two weighted color difference signal. One is U and second one is V. Right. So, the input to the color matrix is RGB, that is red color, green color and blue color. The output of color matrix, it is Y, U and V signal. Now, Y signal, it is provided to the delay line, and because of this particular block delay or delay line, the name it is given PALD encoder. So, in this particular PALD, the abbreviation D is related with your delay line. So, phase alternation by line is the full form of your PAL, and D stands for delay line. And that delay time, it is nothing but 64 microsecond. Now the question arises in front of us, why we are giving such a kind of delay for the luminance signal Y? Dear student, as all of we know that there is a U and V signal, and when we want to modulate that particular signal and want to do some color processing on U and V signal, it will take some time. So for generating your U plus JV and U minus JV signal, it needs 64 microsecond time. So for matching the timing between your Y signal and the chrominance signal, and to have to reach this signal at the same time to the video signal adder, we are providing some delay to your luminance signal. So the delay of 64 microsecond is provided to the luminance signal, so as that within this 64 microsecond time, the U and V signal gets processed and a perfect chrominance signal will be generated. So for generation of chroma signal, we need 64 microseconds. So for within that particular time, we have to wait your luminance signal for 64 microseconds. So once the chroma signal itself it is generated, the luminance signal will reach to the video signal adder at the same time. So both luminance signal and the chrominance signal will reach to the video signal adder at the same time, and it will be get added so as to generate your composite video signal. This is the only one reason why we are adding a delay line to your luminance signal. Now if we understood the concept of luminance signal and the delay line, then let us have a look over your U and V signal. Dear students, U signal is the weighted color difference signal which is applied to your U modulator, and V signal is also a weighted color difference signal which is applied to your V modulator. Now we have skipped some block in this particular block diagram, but before U modulator there is a block of low pass filter. Before V modulator there is a block of low pass filter. Now why we are using such a kind of low pass filter? Because all these U and V are low frequency signal, and these low frequencies are passed by with the help of your LPF, that is low pass filter. So the low modulating U signal, it is given to the U modulator, and the V modulating signal, low frequency V modulating signal, then it is given to the V modulator. Now as the frequency of U and V it is low, and for sending a signal for a longer distance we have to do some modulation process. So U modulator is provided there, and also the V modulator is provided. Now we are having a modulating signal U, we are having a modulating signal V, but we don't have a carrier, because for doing any kind of modulation process always we need a high frequency carrier. So such a kind of high frequency carrier, it is provided by the block color subcarrier oscillator, and it provides a frequency of 4.43 megahertz, and it is also the frequency of your color bus signal which are added in the back porch of your composite video signal. So the color subcarriers are generated with the help of color subcarrier oscillator, and the frequency of color subcarrier it is 4.43 megahertz. Now dear students, in PIL system always keep in mind that the phase gets altered for every sequential line. So line by line, one by one, the phase gets altered. Now here you have to keep in mind that we are not changing the phase of U signal, but we are altering a phase of V signal. So if for a even line the phase is positive, then for odd lines the phase is negative. So if for the first line the phase is minus JV, then for the second line it is plus JV, then next for next line it is minus JV, then plus JV. So the phase of your V signal gets toggled by line by line. Now exactly we are not changing or toggling the V signal, but we are changing the phase of subcarrier. So before doing the modulation at U modulator, the subcarrier it is directly applied to the U modulator. So in U modulator the modulation takes place with 0° phase shift, so there is no any change in the phase of your U signal, and ultimately the output of your U modulator it is FU. But while giving the signal or subcarrier to the V modulator, the phase of your subcarrier toggles between plus 90° and minus 90°. So here you are using a electronic phase switching circuit and also a switch there. Now to operate such a kind of switch, we are providing some switching signal of 7.8 kilohertz. So once we reach a switching signal of 7.8 kilohertz, the switch toggles between plus 90 to the minus 90. For the next switching signal, it comes from minus 90 to the plus 90. So always for each and every line, the phase shift will occur. So for the first switching signal, it is of plus 90 degree phase shift. Then for the next switching signal, it is of minus 90 degree. So your subcarrier value, it should be always less than plus or minus 90 degree. So such a kind of changing phase of carrier, it is given to the V modulator, and V modulator, in V modulator block, the modulation takes place, and the output of V modulator, it is plus V for the first line, minus V for the second line, or alternately. So it will always toggle between plus and minus FV. So if we demonstrate, or if we label the output of U modulator as FU and the output of V modulator as plus and minus FV, and these two signal gets added within that particular adder, so the output of adder, it is FU plus minus FV, right? So for the first line, the phase is plus, so FU plus FV. For the next line, if the phase is minus, then FU minus FV. So for every alternate line, the phase of V signal gets changed, but your the phase of U signal, it is unchanged or never changed. Now such a kind of FU plus minus FV signal, then it is given to the harmonic filter, and the harmonic filter's output, it is nothing but chroma signal or the chrominance signal. Now for this whole operation, the total time needed, it is of 64 microsecond. So that's why we have added a delay line of 64 microsecond. So both Y signal and the chroma signal will reach the video signal at the same time. Now within this particular video signal adder, these two signals get added, and a composite video signal itself, it is generated. So the output of your video signal adder is nothing but your composite video signal. Now this composite video signal is applied to the amplifier, and the amplification process is carried out. Then this composite video signal passes a different stages. The first is IF modulator, then it is given to the RF converter, and then it is given to the power amplifier. Now the input to the RF converter, it is frequency multiplier and crystal control oscillator. So within this particular block, the signal gets converted into the radio frequencies, so as it is best suitable for the broadcasting purpose. So the radio frequency converted signal, then it is applied to the power amplifier, and within this particular block, the power amplification of the signal itself, it is done. Once the signal gets power amplified, this particular video signal gets power amplified, then it is applied to the vestigial sideband filter. Dear students, in our previous lecture, we discussed that in VSB transmission technique, we are sending a full USB and some part of LSB or the vestige of LSB. We are not sending or transmitting the total LSB. As we know that both LSB and USB contains the same information, then why should we send the both sidebands completely? So as to minimize the bandwidth of that particular channel width of that particular signal, we are sending a full USB and a part of LSB or a vestige of LSB. So that's why such a kind of technique is called as vestigial sideband transmission technique. So such a kind of filtering, it is done in your vestigial sideband filter. So now your video information is completely ready for the transmission. So this video information is then applied to the combining network, and at your combining network, the audio signal from the lower channel and the video signal from your upper channel gets combined, and this combined audio and video signal, then it is given to the antenna with the help of coaxial cable, and through antenna, then this signal is uplinked to the satellite, right? And then the signal will be downlinked to the receiver, which is at nothing but the rooftop of your antenna of your rooftop. Then it is given to the setup box, and then it is demodulated, then given to your television receiver scheme. So whatever the television receiver block diagram, we will discuss in our next lecture. But meanwhile, just understood the concept of your television transmitter. So in brief, I will summarize the whole operation. So this particular transmitter is divided to 3 to 4 sections. One is camera section, then PLD encoder, then sound section and the transmitter section. Then the camera provides 3 output RGB. Then it is given to the color matrix. The output of color matrix is YUV signal. U signal, it is applied to the delay line, which provides 64 microsecond delay to the luminance signal. Then U and signal, V signal gets modulated first. So as we are using a PIL system, so the phase of V signal we are altering for every line. So there is no any phase shift for U signal. So whatever the carrier connected to the U modulator, it is of 0° phase shift. So the whatever modulated signal of U modulator, it is FU. But for a V modulator, we are providing a phase shift of your color subcarrier for alternate line. So the phase shifted signal, it is applied to the V modulator through this particular electronic phase switching circuit. To operate such a kind of electronic phase switching circuit, we are providing a switching signal of 7.8 kilohertz. So once we receive or get the 7.8 kilohertz signal to that particular switch, the switch gets toggled from plus 90 to minus 90 degree for every alternate line. Then as the switch gets toggled, the phase shifting of the subcarrier itself, it is done. So at the output of V modulator, for one line we get a positive FV, and a negative FU for the next line. Now this alternate plus minus FV signal, it is given to the adder. So for the first line, if it is FU plus FV, then for the next line it is FU minus FV. Then this signal, it is given to the harmonic filter. The harmonic filter filters out the any remaining component and just passes the chroma signal. And this chroma signal, it is then given to the video signal adder. Video signal adder combines luminance signal after its delayed process of luminance signal. And the combined signal of luminance and chrominance generates a composite video signal. That composite video signal, it is gets amplified, then converted into the RF radio frequencies with the help of IF modulator, frequency multiplier and crystal control oscillator. Then whatever the RF generated, then it is gets power amplified with the help of power amplifier, then provided to the vestigial sideband technique, because we are using a vestigial sideband technique for video transmission. So filter is provided, which filter out some vestiges of your LSB, and full USB it is transmitted. Then it is given to the combining network. The another input to the combining network, it is from your sound transmitter, FM sound transmitter. As all of we know that for audio transmission, we are using the frequency modulation. So whatever the audio itself connected with the help of microphone, then microphone is a transducer which converts audio information into the electrical information. Then it is applied to the amplifier. Then the amplified signal, it is given to the FM modulator, and carrier is generated with the help of audio carrier. And the output of FM modulator, it is FM signal, that is frequency modulated audio signal. Then it is also given to the combining network. So video and audio gets combined in your combining network, and final television signal, broadcasting signal, it is given to the antenna with the help of coaxial cable, and then it is uplinked to your satellite for your broadcasting purpose. So this is all about the block diagram of color TV transmitter. Hope all of you understood this. So in our next lecture, we are going to discuss the color television receiver. So meanwhile, we will stop here. So thank you. Thank you very much.